In last video, we deployed our functions to Google Cloud. In this video, we are going to create a mobile app in React Native, which will make a call to Google Cloud and do the prediction. Now, React Native is a framework by Facebook wherein you can write code and run it on both Android and iOS. It is a very hot technology. If you have knowledge of React Native, you will get a job very easily, either as a software engineer or it can help you in data science field as well. First, let's do some setup. You can go to my GitHub page. The link of this page is in video description below and go to a section where it says that setup for React Native app. Click on this link, open this and this page, go to this tab, okay? Don't click on Expo CLI. Come here, then select your OS, let's say, we are Windows, correct? So Windows and Android. If you're Mac or Linux, I mean, select appropriately and follow these instructions very carefully. If you miss any step, you will face a lot of issues. Therefore, you need to read this page carefully and install Chocolaty, install OpenJDK by running this choco install command, install Android Studio, set up your environment variable as they have shown here, and stop when you come to this point. So you don't need to follow the page after this. Okay, so I hope you follow all these steps. You have installed everything. Now let's go to the next step. So the next step is you need to go to mobile app directory. So you git clone this particular folder and that has a subfolder called mobile app. So on my computer, what I'm going to do is here, you see mobile app. So in here, I will just clear everything. Let's assume you are here. And if you do ls, you have mobile app folder. So you're going to mobile app folder and running yarn install. Because see, that's what it says here, right? Yarn install. If you don't have yarn install or yarn install on your computer, Google is a friend. Okay, install yarn. How do you install yarn? Well, npm install global yarn. By running this command, you can install yarn. I have already installed this thing, so my yarn command is going to run. When you do yarn install, what it will do is it will go through all your dependencies and install on those dependencies into this node modules folder. Now I have already installed everything. That's why you know, it just came up like in a 0.36 second, but for you, it's gonna take some time. So what it does internally is it will create this node modules folder and install all these dependencies. By dependencies, you know, in Python, when you do import sklearn, sklearn is a dependency. And that gets installed when you do pip install something sklearn inside packages, it will install sklearn. Similarly, when you do yarn install, it will look at all the dependencies in your package.json or yarn.lock. Yarn, you can run npm as well. Npm yarn are kind of alternatives, and it will install all those dependencies from package.json into node modules. Okay. So these are all the modules that we have. All right, what's the next step? Next step is copy env example as .env. So in my this folder, my env.example is basically, I have opened that here. This is an example file, okay? So I have this URL, but you need to copy that as .env. So I did control C, control V, and then renamed it to .env. And that .env file, I put my own Google Cloud Functions link. You should have your own Google Cloud instance as per our last video, and you should put that link. Don't put my link, it might not work. So you have to put your own link into .env file. Now the step number 2.1 is only for Mac users. So remember, if you're a Windows user, don't worry about this step. But if you are a Mac user, you need to install Cocoa pod. Okay, so otherwise pod command will not work. Whenever you see something like, okay, command not found, just Google and install that particular thing. But yeah, if you're a Windows user, do not worry about this step. All right, now the next step is running the app. So you come to running the app section. In that, running the app, yes, you can just run npm run android command. Now before you run that, you need to install, you need to have a virtual device installed. You know, virtual device as in on the same page. Okay, you know, we had some steps on on the same page, basically setting up, you know, environment setup. You need to go to this one, create a new AVD, and follow the steps to create a virtual device on your computer. So if I'm in Android Studio here, this is my Android Studio. If I go to Tools, AVD Manager, initially this list will be empty. So what I did is I created a new virtual device. These are all the Android phones out there. So I chose Pixel 2, click Next. Make sure you select Q29, see, API level 29, next, and it will create this virtual device right here. Now, what is this virtual device? Well, the virtual device, let me just close this thing here. When you click on this, it will run an emulator on your computer. So this looks just like your Android phone, see? This is like your Android phone, but it's an emulator on the computer. So when you are doing any mobile app development, these emulators are pretty useful. You can write a code, deploy to this virtual device, test it, iteratively do that. You don't have to deploy your code every time to your mobile phone. So that's the purpose of these virtual devices. And you need to create at least one virtual device. I'm going to just exit this, close this, and go back to my directory here and run npm run android. If you're running iOS application, npm run iOS. And if your setup is fine, you will not get any error and it will launch the emulator. See, it is launching the virtual device and then it is deploying your code onto this device. So see, my code is deployed. My code is in this directory, correct? Mobile app, you see? I have all my code. So it ran that code here and now you can start using the application. So I'm going to click on this icon and select few images. So when you click on this icon, initially this folder will be empty. So what you can do is, so I will go to, you know, I have this test images from internet directory. So just drag and drop these files here and it will kind of copy it. You might not see it initially, but you might have to close this emulator, start again, but eventually you will see this. And in here, I'm just going to select one image. So now what's happening is it selected that image. Behind the scene, it is calling Google Cloud function for inference. And which Google Cloud function it is calling? This one. Whatever you specify in .env, it is making a call to that particular function. And see, voila, it worked. It says 76.68% confidence. So the mobile application is kind of ready, working on your computer. And if you want to push this to Google Play Store, I have instructions for that as well. So on the same page, when you go to running the app, I think it is somewhere here. So running the app and deploying it, let me find, yes, here. So if you click on this link, creating a public, you know, public API or kind of pushing it to Google Play Store, if you follow these instructions, you will be able to deploy your application to Google Store. Now going back to code, The code is quite similar to the code we saw for website. Website was built in React.js. Mobile application is built in React Native. Now the code will be mostly similar. There might be some changes. Some changes as in, you know, the dimensions for the mobile application is different. So then you will do something like this. But other than that, code is kind of similar. You are using all the libraries from React Native and things like Axios that we use for React.js website. We are using the same Axios library here, and it makes an HTTP call to our backend. Okay, so go through this code. If you don't know React Native, if you want to get some idea on React Native, you can go to YouTube, find some tutorials. I wish you have enjoyed watching this series with me and you have learned some important concepts on how to build a deep learning project end to end. I did not get a chance to cover TF Lite, so in the future I might upload one or two videos on TF Lite and show you how you can deploy TF Lite model on the mobile device itself rather than making a call to HTTP function in GCP cloud. So if I get a chance, I will upload those videos in the same playlist, so keep an eye on it. But if you like this series, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends who can also, you know, get some benefits out of this awesome project experience. This is an end-to-end project series. This is how the projects are executed in corporate. So it's gonna give you a lot of good exposure on, you know, building the whole application end-to-end. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And if you have any question, please post in a comment box below.